How's it going, guys? Today I'm doing a very highly requested video, how to play the puck as a goalie. A lot on Instagram specifically, I'm getting a lot of requests for this video, so I thought I'd deliver and give you guys the way that I learned how to play the puck and the various methods which a lot of goalies play the puck. But before I get into the video, I have one quick message. Here in my garage. Just got this new hockey sauce kit here. Fun to play around with. In California, I guess. But you know what I like more than materialistic hockey things? Subscribing to the Tendy Life YouTube channel, that's right. It'll literally take you 2 seconds, just pause this video, go subscribe to the YouTube channel, click the subscribe button below, click the notification bell as well so you're notified every single time I upload. And also go follow me on Instagram, at Tendy Life. I have so many followers, almost 19,000 over there. It's a huge platform. So go follow me over there as well, at Tendy Life, and let's try to grow YouTube to just as big of a platform. Go subscribe. And I also wanna thank the Hockey Sauce Kit for sending me their awesome product. I'm gonna have a full review video and also a first impressions video, an unboxing video this week or maybe next week, coming very soon, but they have a really awesome product. Really cool, have the mini nets and you can play a lot of games with it. You can practice your shot and I'll definitely be using it for this video about playing the puck. So they sent me two nets, two ice pads, and some pucks. And it's a really, really unique product and I'm really glad to be working with them. So I'm gonna leave the link in the description of this video to go to their site if you're interested in purchasing one of those, and they have an awesome product. So just wanted to thank them. So let's start with one of the two methods, which is the classic method. So the classic method is where you'll have, obviously, your blocker hand at the top, but you'll have your glove hand like this. And essentially, you'll use this hand for your power below and you'll follow through just like that. It's called the classic position or the classic way of playing the puck because this was the most popular way for goalies to do it up until a few years ago, or I believe like a decade or two ago. For example, Marty Brodeur was someone who really used this method a lot. Was using what's now called the classic method, which is putting your hand, your T, facing the ground or facing the ice, and then falling through with your bottom hand to gain your power. This is not the way that I play the puck, however, it was the way I used to play the puck before I found a different tactic. I have used this method in the past, but this is not one that I've found to be most effective for me. The second, which is the more modern method, and this was really started by Marty Turco, was putting your glove hand, your glove tee upwards, and then gripping your stick with your glove hand. So basically, you're gonna grasp your stick. You're really gonna use your bottom hand to again get power, but you'll have a little bit more leverage because you're grasping on your stick in a different way. So you're getting a little bit more leverage, getting a little bit more flex in your stick and following through just like you would the other way, except this way I found, to, at least for me, be more comfortable. And it's kind of called, also nicknamed the Turco method, because goaltender Marty Turco was one of the first to use it. It does help to have a really good or good closing glove with this method. As you can see, I have my factory mat glove here. It closes perfectly whenever I need it to, so I can grip the stick really well. When you're using this method for the best results, you want to be able to hold your stick in your glove hand. So take a look at this. You basically want to be able to hold your stick, grip it really tight so you can hold it with your glove hand, just like this. Fortunately, my GoPro died mid-video, so I'm just switching to my phone, so I apologize if there's a difference in quality as far as video or audio goes. As far as comparing and contrasting these two methods, the Turco method I've found is harder to learn at first. It took me a long time to learn how to actually shoot with that method, but once I learned to do it, I found it a lot easier to shoot with, a lot easier to get really good at shooting the puck with. I've found that the classic method is it's a little easier to learn to flick the puck up, you know, like flick it up, like get your blade under it, just kind of flick it, and learn to shoot lightly, but it's really hard to use that method in a practical way on the ice. I found that the Turco method at least works better for me after I've learned how to use it. And that's just my preference as well, and a lot of other goalies have their own ways of playing the puck. I think there's one goalie, I forget what country they're from, but they actually use a different type of stick. So instead of using a lefty stick, because I have a right blocker, and they would be using a righty stick, and they actually flip it around, and they shoot the puck righty, and they put their glove hand up here. I don't know how people would do that, So there are some anomalies out there, I guess, with some goalies. However, these two strategies are the most practical and the most used, widely used, I guess, among most goalies. And as far as learning to play the puck, the only real advice I could give as far as getting better at it is just practicing a lot. I was lucky enough to where my goalie coach would actually have me out to help out with some of the younger kids at his goalie lessons, like maybe like squirts or peewees, so I'd be able to pass the puck during their drills or even start shooting the puck in their drills once I got better. And just going out like once or twice a week and having that repetition of learning to play the puck and learning to shoot the puck and gaining the arm strength necessary and getting the technique down, that helped me so much, like unbelievably much. So if you want to really get better at playing the puck, the main thing I can say is just practice. Just find some time and a couple times a week and just start ripping some shots and keep practicing. That's the best way you're going to be able to learn to play the puck.
So now I'm just going to show you guys some film of me using these two various different methods. I'm going to be using the Hockey Sauce Kit, obviously. Thank you guys so much over at the Hockey Sauce Kit for sending me your product. And I'm just kind of shooting the pucks around, showing you the two methods in practice. And again, the real key with learning how to play the puck as good as possible, I guess, is making sure that you practice a lot. So if you can just find a place or a time or somewhere and practice shooting the puck as much as possible a couple times a week, eventually you'll get the technique down and eventually you'll get more power in your arm strength and eventually you'll be able to play the puck much more efficiently. I'm gonna leave this video here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you kind of like this style of video a little bit differently than my normal way. Normally I just do a voiceover video with some film, but I thought I'd try a different way of recording this video, and I think it turned out okay. But this is the first video I've kind of done in this style, so hopefully it'll get better in the future. But let me know what you want to see from me in future videos. Look for 3 uploads per week in the future, and I'm really excited to start making some more content for you guys. Thanks again to the Hockey Sauce Kit for sending me their product. I'll have a review and unboxing on that probably within this week or next week, and of course I'll put the link to buy their product in the description of this video. It's a really awesome product. I highly recommend it. And please subscribe and then put down in the comments what kind of videos you want to see from me in the future. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.